Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I'm Vikram. In this class, we'll try to solve some problems, problem number 1 and problem number 2 on direct mapping. The concepts related to the direct mapping has been clearly explained in our previous videos. If you haven't watched those videos, please watch those videos and come back here. And every video in our channel is going to be a part of entire course or a playlist. Our suggestion is to follow the entire course so that you can have better understanding of the concepts. And the link for the playlist is provided in the description below. Now coming to this class, this is our first problem. We'll try to solve this problem. So let's try to solve this problem. Here what they are stating is, consider a direct mapped cache of size 16 kilobytes. So cache memory size, we'll take the short forms, it is cache memory size is 16 kilobytes. Kilo means 2 power 10, 16 means 2 power 4. So it is 2 power 14 bytes. It is 2 power 14 bytes of cache memory. So 2 power 14 means, so 0th byte, first byte, second byte, and the last one is 2 power 14th byte. This is 2 power 14th byte. Okay. So it is kilo means 2 power 10. 2 power 10, and this is 2 power 4. So if you do the product of it, it is going to be 2 power 14 bytes. Just for your understanding, I have elaborated this because it is our first problem with block size of 256 bytes. So what is the block size? They are saying BS means block size. Block size, so each block, so now what we are going to do is 2 power 56 bytes. So from this, so block means it is for main memory, but the cache we call it as a line. But the number of words or bytes in the line or block are same. So the discussion in that, we have already discussed that. So every line of the cache is going to have 256. So 0 to 255 means 256 bytes. Every line, so we are going to group all this into one group. So for each group we are going to have 256 bytes. So it is a 256 bytes. In powers of 2, it is 2 power 8. Okay, so it is 2 power 8 bytes per line or per block of the main memory. The size of the main memory is 128 kilobytes. Main memory size, MMS means main memory size, is 128 kilobytes. Okay, kilo means it is 2 power 10. Again, 128 means it is 2 power 7. Okay, so total it is 2 power 17 bytes. The main memory size is 2 power 17 bytes. Now what they are asking is number of bits in tag. So whenever we, address format, so the address lines is going to have, so the number of bits in the tag and tag directory size. So as we have said that the main memory size is 2 power 17 bytes. 2 power 17 bytes means, this is main memory. For example, if it is 0th bit, this is going to be 2 power 17th bit. This is going to be 2 power 17th byte. Okay. So this main memory, in this main memory, we are going to group 256 number of bytes into one group. As we have said that it is block size is 256 bytes. We are going to group them into one group, and with that we are going to get the block size. Okay, this is what we call it as a block. So now what they are asking is number of bits in the tag. So the cache memory address, how the address, so the total number of bits in the main memory, address bits are the total number of bits required to identify each and every byte, is 17 bits are required. 2 power 17 bytes are there in order to represent each and every byte of the memory uniquely. We need 17 bits. Okay, so this is 17 bits, and as we have said that 256 are made into one group. So what is the block offset? So as we have said that, what is the block offset? Block offset is 2 power 8 bytes are made into one group. The block offset needs 8 bits. Block offset means to represent every word in the block, to represent every word in the block, we need 8 bits. As we are having 256 bytes, we need 8 bits to represent every word in the block. So that is very important to understand. So the block size is 8 and the total number of bits required to represent is 17 bits. And number of bits required to represent the block number? 17 minus 8, it is 9 bits are required for block number. So this is block number and this is block offset. So the block offset value is 8 and the block number value is 9. So coming to the cache memory, so in order by using the same 17 bit address, how we are going to identify whether the required word is present in the cache memory or not? So that we have already discussed how the cache memory address will be, how the address, physical address, will be divided to identify the content is present in the cache memory or not. We have to divide it into 3 parts. So this part is a block or line offset. So both are same because the size of block is same for both the main memory and the cache memory. So we are going very slow because to get habituated to the contents. So to get habituated to the terminology, block or line offset. Block offset or line offset, both are same. So the number of bits required for line offset is 8 bits. Again, so in the line, in each line of the cache memory, in order to identify every word, every byte uniquely, we need 8 bits. Okay, so next is line number. So with how many lines are there, how do we get that? It is very important to understand. The cache memory is 2 power 14 bits and each line is of size 2 power 8 bits. How to get the number of lines? So number of lines in cache memory is equal to 2 power 14 by 2 power 8. So out of 2 power 14 bytes, we are grouping them into 2 power 8. So by dividing this, we are going to get 2 power 6. Here 2 power 6 number of lines are there in this cache memory. As every line is going to have 2 power 8 number of bytes, so the number of lines that we are going to have is 2 power 6. So in order to represent each and every line uniquely, we need 6 bits. So this is line number. As we have discussed that out of 17 bits, the same physical address value is used to represent, is used in the cache memory also. So out of 17 bits, 8 bits are used for block offset, 6 bits are used for line number. This is used for line number. And the remaining bits for tag. So this is what we call it as tag bits, right? How many bits are required for tag? It is 17 minus 14. So number of bits required in the tag are 3 bits are required. And the next question, the number of tag bits in the tag are 3. The next question is tag directory size. What is meant by tag directory size? For example, if you take 4 lines in a cache memory and each tag is having 2 bits. So 2 bits are there means each tag is having 2 bits means tag directory size means the sum of all these bits. How many bits are required for the entire tags? So we are having 2 bits per tag. So the tag directory size in bits is, it is going to have 8 bits. Number of tags into number of bits in tag, number of tag bits, tag bits. So we are having four tags for this cache memory. We are having four tags, and the number of tag bits are two per tag. We are going to have two bits, so the number of the tag directory size is 8 bits. If we convert it to, it is 8 bits. If we convert into bytes, 8 by 8, which is equal to 1 byte. Okay, so that is what we call it as tag directory size. So for our example, what is the tag directory size? The number of lines in the cache memory is 2 power 6. It is 2 power 6 into 3. 2 power 6 means 64 into 3. So these are the number of bits that we are going to get for tag directory size. So you can do the math. So 64 into 3, we are going to get 192 bits. 192 bits are required for tag directory size. By 8 we are going to get the number of bits. So by 8 we are going to get the number of bits. Okay, so coming to our next problem, let's try to solve the next problem. So from here on we will try to do a bit faster. Okay, so the direct mapped cache of size 512 cache memory size is equal to 512 kilobytes, which is equal to 2 power 10 into 512 means 2 power 9, which is equal to 2 power 19 bytes, and with a block size of 1 KB. 1 KB means it is 2 power 10 bytes. There are 7 tag bits, as they are saying that for cache memory there are 7 bits, tag bits. These are tag bits, and this is line number, and this is line offset. Okay, so they have mentioned that there are 7 bits in it, and we are having a cache size of 512 KB, and they are asking for size of the main memory. What is the size of the main memory they are asking? And they are asking the tag directory size. So here cache memory, we are having 2 power 19 bytes. So to get the number of lines, with that we are going to get the line number. To get the number of lines, it is 2 power 19. So the number of bytes are 2 power 19. And what is the block size or line size? Block size and line size are same. The block size is 2 power 10. In order to get the number of lines in the cache memory, it is 2 power 19 by 2 power 10, which is equal to 2 power 9 lines. Number of lines is equal to 2 power 9. Okay, it is number of lines. Number of lines are 2 power 9. So the line numbers, in order to represent each and every line uniquely, how many bits we need? We need 9 bits. So line number is 9 bits. So the line offset is with the block size, we are going to get the line offset. Block offset or line offset, both are same. Block size is 2 power 10 bytes. So the number of bits required to represent the line, each line is going to have 2 power 10 bytes. So this is represented by 10. So the total number of bits, that the CPU generates in order to get the address is, it is 10 plus 9 plus 7, which is 26. 26 bits are required. So the main memory size is 2 power 26, which means 2 power 20 is equal to 1 MB. So the number of 2 power 6. So the main memory size is 2 power 6 MB. The main memory size is 2 power 6 MB. And similarly, the size of the main memory we have identified, it is 2 power 6 MB. Tag directory size. So as we have said that tag directory means the number of bits that are required in each tag multiplied by the number of tags. The number of tags is equal to number of lines. The number of lines are 2 power 9. number of lines are 2^9 and each tag is having 7 bits. With this we are going to get 2^9 into 7 number of bits, and dividing that by 8 we are going to get the number of bytes. That is what we call it as a tag directory size. Please do the math for it. It is 2^9 into 7. With that we are going to get the number of bits required for tag directory. So the entire size of the tag we are going to get, and dividing by 8 we are going to get that value into bytes. Okay, so these are the two problems that we have solved. In our next video we'll try to solve some more problems. Hope you got the clarity on this concept. If you have any doubts regarding these problems, please post your doubts in the comment section below. And if you feel that this video is helpful to you, please give us a like symbol and please share this video with your friends. And thanks for watching.